today I thought of having a detailed discussion about the spectrosample polishing machine that we sell. So here is the prototype model of the machine, and I wanted to have this discussion for a long time. The reason being, the market is getting so volatile, and people are selling the machines and the parts at a throwaway prices. So why we sell this machine at a reasonable price, and why our charges seems to be higher? The reason is because this is being one of the best quality machine that is being manufactured here in India. So basically it's a Make in India campaign that we have launched. So if you could just see, have a look at this catalog, right? So this is exactly the machine that you can see here also. Now if we compare the machine features, then let us start with the technical specification of the machine. So, presently this is one of the best technically superior machine that is available in the world today for the spectrosampling. So here we are using two different set of motors, both of them being aligned for 3000 RPM working, and most of the features have been standardized as per the ASTM requirement. Other than that, the documentation has been very precise and has been revised from time to time. So we have come up with the fifth volume of the Spectro's manual, basically, right? So again, why we are changing these things? This is for the set of our customers. The new things that we do, the new improvements that we are coming up with in the machine. So we thought of demonstrating and talking to our customers directly for this. So I thought of making this video for my existing customer as well as the future prospective customers that we may have. Now there are some silent features that we have in this machine. So let me discuss about them one by one. So number one is, people say it's a high RPM machine, single fixed speed machine. So I want to make it clear, we do manufacture the variable speed machines also. But if you go to the ASTM standards and the type of machine that has been recommended by ASTM, it says that you need to have more than 2800 RPMs at that also fixed, because the type of surface that is required for the spectrometer testing doesn't change. The spark stand of the spectrometer doesn't change, the sparking electrode doesn't change. So we need to have a very precise and same type of samples, one time, second time, every time. Hence we need to have a precise single speed machine that is recommended. It is not that because we are manufacturing, it has been recommended by the ASTM and thus it is being followed worldwide. So we go according to the standards only, right? So that is number one. Number two is, there are people who are using a very low RPM motor for the main dish. They have changed the material of the main dish that we use. Now the main dish that we use here, inside this, so the base plate that is basically manufactured by a LM8 aluminium alloy. Now what is the difference in that? So LM8 is basically the aluminium alloy that is being used for the aerodynamics, means the planes, the helicopters. So that has to, why we have made it? because at 3000 rpm it should not lose its balancing. It has to run for a very longer time, so it will sustain for a longer period, so the life of the machine is going to be higher. So that is one reason. Now we were probably the first in the world to come up with a spectropolisher machine which has the auto suction and blower system both incorporated in a very precise and short form, right? So it's a unique technology which we call static vacuumization. We don't use any vacuum pump in this machine, but still we try to generate a vacuum inside the machine. Now why that vacuum? The vacuum is basically to hold on the polishing paper dish tightly, and it acts as a longer life. So with the same polishing paper, single paper, you can have more number of samples. Suppose the ordinary machine that you have, ordinary paper that you have in the market, so you might be able to polish 25 to 30 samples from one single polishing medium dish, right? Abrasive paper I'm talking about. So from our machine you can have from 75 samples up to 100. So it's a huge difference, 25 samples versus 75 samples. So if you calculate the cost of difference in the cost of one sampling, so that again within a year the cost that you have incurred in this machine, it will get free. And every year you will have the recurring saving in form of consumables for that. That is number one. Number two, nowadays in the market there are companies like, I don't want to name them, okay, in India also there are companies which would manufacture machine with non-standardized dimensions. Now what I mean by non-standardized dimension is this main aluminium dish, the plate that we use, so basically as a standard it is 350 mm dia. Now the 350 mm dia is 14 inch basically, so 14 inch dia. Now there are people who are making the machine with 9 inch dia, so that would require a special polishing paper. You will have to procure it from them every time. So again, that is a marketing technique. We use standardized paper that is being manufactured by the two world-class companies, Grindwell Norton, and second is Cargo Random Universal. So 350 mm dia, 60 grit paper that is universally available all over the globe, and we recommend the standard size only, so that the customer can get those things from wherever they have their plants. They don't have to come to us for those small consumables also. Okay, so that is number two. Number three is the working of this machine, why it has evolved. So it we are into this market now for more than almost 20 years. So 20 years is a very long time to sustain in this market. That is why you would have seen that we never came up with any type of videos or any promotional work, because we genuinely work for the quality of the machine and we deliver it to our customers. But now we feel that there is a need to show what we are making, because people are showing things, and there are few people claim false things. So in order to counter them, we need to have some such videos where we try to demonstrate you what we have in our machines. Okay, so that was about the main polishing dish. Now second thing that comes is the type of motor that we use in the machine. So these are the special type of motors we manufacture. It is TEFC type motors, and it's a 90 frame size motor, which normally is used in 3 HP, 5 HP and the higher capacity motors only. Why we are using that? We can use a single 1 HP motor also in same machine, but that would not last longer. If your sample load increases, the motor will burn out. Now if you take our machine, we have customer today whom we supplied the machine way back in 2007, so 13-14 years back, and still those people are using the machine, the same motor is there. So that is the advantage of it. Again, we are using a second separate motor of 1 HP for the suction purpose also. Now why the suction is so vital? The suction is so vital because when the machine is operating on a motor at 3000 RPM speed, so that is going to generate heat because of the abrasion. Abrasion when we are pushing the sample towards the running motor plate. Okay, so if the heat is generated, we need to have a suction which takes away the dirt and the heat and blows it out. Again, that is a static vacuumization technique why we use, right? So because of that, this is some of the unique features of the machine which we are discussing with you today. That is for the first time we have never disclosed internal of our machine, but now we are talking to you directly. Okay, so I would always be happy to have your feedbacks on these things. What other people manufacture, what did you find? So that would be a good interaction between you and us. So that was the reason for the two different motor and a higher capacity motors. That increases the cost of our machine, you can understand that, right? Now third comes is the suction pump. Okay, so the pump that we use in our machine, you can see it at the back of the machine, it is there. Okay, so that is the centrifugal type pump. Again, for working of that pump also, we are using a 3000 RPM motor, 1 HP motor. The reason is the suction has to be equivalent, it has to balance with the speed of the main motor. If you have a lower suction machine, probably your machine, you cannot claim that it will suck out the dust, because the flow of the dust is so high, because it's the main motor is running at 3000 RPM speed. So we need to have a balanced motor. There are few people who run their suction pump, they claim that even 1400 RPM motor is sufficient. Why do we need such a high RPM motor? So there are reasons. There is a logic, there is a science. We need to balance it in the same machine. Hence we are using it. And that is adding to the cost of the machine, the type of suction pump we have. So it is adding the cost. But to the customer, we are delivering something that is of the highest value. And this is the model. Right now I'm sitting with this machine model, so that is the model which is our export model. We are exporting to a few different countries. We have exported it to Europe also, Russia, Georgia, South Africa, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. Then in South Africa also there are a couple of countries where we have supplied this machine. Hence, I am discussing today about this machine with all of you, all my customers, all around the globe. The third thing that comes is the electrification of this machine. Now, why that is again different? Why that is costly? So there are reasons to it, right? Now, the reason being, people can use a simple LNT on-off switch directly, which is connected to the motor and directly connected to the mains. Why we are using a panel board with auto cutout system having contactor relay setting in this machine? for both the motors. So there is a reason. If there is any problem with the power, the fluctuation, so in that case the whole machine should not get damaged. Hence our panel board cost us more than 10,000 rupees. Still we are making this. There are people in the market who would say that the machine cost high. So these are the reasons for it. And the people who believe in quality would understand it. Okay. So that is about, I just want to show you also. See. So inside you can see. Right. Now again there are small things that we have in our machine. One of them is the brake assembly. Normally in these type of polishers, very few machines are fully operational with their braking system. So here we have a brake in two forms. One is the mechanical type we have for the lower versions, and for the higher versions, export versions, we have electrically controlled braking system. That is very essential. Why it is essential? Because from the safety point of view, if there is some problem, if the sample, the man who is polishing, if he loses hold of that sample, so if you are not able to stop the machine immediately, it could have some sort of accident. So that is why this is also again very important. Hence we have this feature also. Now again, over a period of time, the size and the height has been questioned for these type of machine. But why do we need to have this height only? So there is a reason for that also, which is mentioned very clearly in the standards, in the ISO standards, that ergonomically, when a person who is in a standing position has to polish the samples, so the height of that machine has to be more than 2.5 feet, the table height. If you have a polishing machine which is lower in height, so it, the person who is working with that machine will have problems, health issues in a longer run. If I have to keep on doing this way and again take sample, again do this, so that is going to create a problem with my back someday, isn't it? So again, the people who questions the height, who changes the height for them, I have to say please don't change it. It is for the safety and the health of the, not the person who has made it, it is for them who are going to use it, the customers who don't know us, who don't know who has made it. But health is an issue, so we are trying to indirectly address that issue also by maintaining the height as per the standard norms that are mentioned in the ISO and which are being followed worldwide. Okay. Other than that, what features we have in the machine? So there are very small things which I want to convey to you here. Now see, if the machine, there are 70% of the manufacturer of the machine who do not place a label. Now why labeling is important? Labeling is important because number one, it has the serial number of the machine, it has the year of manufacturing of the machine. So the customer don't need to remember these things, whether it is in warranty, whether the spares are available. Because of the continuous development, even we also would be in need of these details. Because after 5 years, if you come to me for spare of this machine, so I should know that this machine was in June 2020. Okay, so that model, what features we had, I can straightway go to the spare section and get the correct spare for you first time. Okay, now if we are discussing about the spares, I must show you that we have already included this in our manual, the list of spares. So this is as per the international standards. Okay, even the smallest screw, nut, bolt that is being used in our machine, that is mentioned in it. So that was about the spares. Now I also want to make one thing clear about the availability of the spares. So 100% of our machines spare of all the model we have manufactured and we are manufacturing, we are supporting customer for the coming 15 years. For 15 years you can anytime come to us for spare and we will be selling you the spares. There are people in the market who would import it from China. If you ask for the spare, they don't have spares. So we don't want to do that. Right? So the spares, the availability of the spares, it is with us. We are with you for that. Right? So that was the thing. Now there are some other features also. If you see in the bottom of the machine, why we have made a special rack, I'll try to show you. See, so this rack, right? So this has been made especially, it is a design aspect only. There are people don't, their machine's height is the same, they don't have these things. We have thought of customer that okay, there is a space, let us create some useful space within the machine itself where you can keep the spares and consumable related to this machine inside, within the machine only. So that's a great idea actually, for the benefit of the customer. Now again, other than that, there are small things. See, if you see this panel, right, so it is for basically use of opening the clamping nut for the replacement of the paper. Now over a period of time we have increased the length of the handle. Now this is the safety aspect we have taken into consideration, because the initial model had, I have to hold it so closely. Now what is, I can hold it so long, right? So now I am easily able to hold, and safe also. Safety is the main thing. So thinking from the customer's point of view, we have improvised upon this. Now there are machines where you will not find this completely single attached body. They assemble it. Now this plate is different. It is mounted on some bolts. Now I must tell you, there is a huge risk of accident in those machines, because here is the motor where you have the dish which is rotating at 3000 rpm, and if this part is detachable, sometime if there is some problem, this ring could get thrown away, and if there are people around, they'll have problem. But don't worry, with our machine absolutely no problem. It's a single base, body base attached machine. Absolutely no problem. Okay, so this was about the body structure. Now one of the vital point that I wanted to come to was the weight of the machine. The weight of our machine, it is around 300 kgs I would say. So why so heavy machine? If you would have seen any polisher machine which is operating at a high speed, so those machines basically have a lot of vibration at 3000 rpm, right? So this machine would keep on vibrating and moving if it is lightweight. Now this machine is a very heavy weight. So there is even no need of foundation bolting in this machine. The weight of the machine is sufficient to absorb the vibration that are being created by running this machine. So that is the key reason, key feature, though a small one but very thoughtful. That is why we have a machine which is having more weight, almost 3 times the weight of the machine that are available in the market. Right now there are machines which are weighing not more than, few machines weigh around 50 kg to 100 kg. We have a machine which is having 300 kgs, right? So these are the features I always wanted to talk to you, to my customers, to my prospective clients, to the people who want to buy our products. So this video is basically meant for this whole technical discussion about our machine. And I would welcome your queries. Once I post this video, you can always ask your queries in the comment section, or you can even mail it to us. That's all in this video. Thank you.
My mail is given in the description.
My email ID, if you want to note down, so that is sandeep@magnumopusinternational.com. And for more details, you can always visit my company's website also. You'll find this logo. The website name is www.magnumopusinternational.com. Thank you once again. Bye.